Hi everyone. Today I will present you Phase Manager, the dedicated configuration software for Phase. We'll review its most important features, and I will give you the tips for you to discover all that this software has to offer. Phase Manager allows you to configure and monitor your phase, and also access the latest updates and features available. To access Phase Manager, download it directly on mwm-store.com/configuration. For this tutorial, we will use the Mac OS version, but both PC and Mac versions are the same. Open the app and log into your MWM account. If you have just created an account, don't forget to check all your inbox tabs and spam folders to validate your mail. Now that you're logged in, connect your phase to your computer by plugging the receiver via USB. On the main view, you should notice that your phase is well connected and recognized by Phase Manager. You'll notice that the connecting LED at the back of the receiver sometimes blinks. It's normal, and means that the receiver is sending or receiving information from the laptop. On the main view, you can find a quick overview of your product information and also the installed firmware version of your receiver, as well as your remotes. Whenever an update is available, a red button will indicate it and guide you to the update center. Check out our video tutorial about updating Phase to know more about the process. One key aspect of the main view in Phase Manager is that it displays real-time information about your product. For example, here, I know that the remote A is charging and that it is linked to the receiver. If the status says unlinked, it means the remote is not connected to the receiver and cannot communicate with it. However, the remote can still charge. Click on the info icon to know more about each one of the remote's status. Another important section of Phase Manager is the settings. By clicking on settings, you access different sections to complete your phase configurations, such as the setup configuration where you can select your preferred DJ software, or the color picker where you can customize the LED colors of your phase. You can also access an important feature, the manual calibration. In some cases, it can happen that the sensors aren't properly calibrated and that you notice a difference of speed in your DJ software between the remotes and the turntables. If that happens, proceed to do a manual calibration of the remotes. This will ensure the remote's speed is the same as the turntables. To do so, take the remotes out of the receiver, place them on your spinning turntables at a proper plus or minus zero pitch, and follow the indicated steps. In the other setting tabs, you will also find advanced features such as the reset function and the remote shutdown. Resetting your phase will re-establish the default settings. This action is only advised in some specific troubleshooting situations supervised by one of our support team members. You will also find other custom tools that are addressed to advanced users and will evolve with time depending on the needs of performers. Lastly, the section called About This Phase will let you register your phase to your MWM account and give it a proper name. Don't forget to click on Save each time you modify your settings before returning back to the main view. Now back at the main view, you will find additional information in the headers such as blog articles, newsletter subscription, and troubleshoot access should you need it at any point. If you have any questions, please visit mwm-store.com or contact us at support@mwm-store.com. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't yet to be notified when a new video is out, and let us know your thoughts in the comments. Thanks again, and we'll see you out there soon.